125 championship here in AMA competition. And right now, the pressure is building. The gate will drop. We'll find out how those two, who are gated right next to each other, make it into the first turn. It looks like Lampson got the better of Ryan Hughes, with Mike Brown slotting there into second place. A Suzuki looked like Damon Huffman there, slotting into third. So, a crash in the first turn. One of those is Wyndham, who of course finished third in moto number one. But at the moment, Steve Lampson has the hole shot, things going exactly as he has hoped, David.
Well, the other good news for Lampson is the fact that Ryan in that second corner got pushed wide. He was looked like he may have been able to come out in third. He's further back, fifth or sixth right now, and he's got a Honda of Troy back there, and that's going to help him relax.
Steve Lampson, he got the hole shot. He said he had arm pump. You see Ryan Hughes there in fourth place, not very far away, still has a great opportunity to close in. But he said, I had arm pump in moto number one. I think I've shaken it. If he has, that's going to make it very tough for Ryan Hughes.
Well, it did look as though that Steve Lampson was riding faster than Ryan Hughes at the end of moto number one. And if he can continue that, it's going to be a tough moto for Ryan Hughes. And you can see he's already, he's almost 100 yards behind the leader. And they're both on Honda, so I don't know if that makes it any worse for Ryan Hughes, but I'm sure it doesn't help.
Of course, we're talking about Mike Brown, number 26, and Michael Craig, number 19, both on Honda of Troy, Honda support riders. How much do you think they would try and help Lampson?
Well, I don't think it's on their agenda to do just that, but they're not going to make it any easier. I'm sure that if they want to ride from Honda, if they could make it any easier for Steve Lampson to win this title, Honda wouldn't be mad at him. And if they need parts in the future, it probably wouldn't be too tough to get. Remember that time I helped Lampson win a title? Well, can I get that pipe? You never know what kind of things go on, but that could be in the back of their mind.
Steve Lampson right now doesn't care who has to help him. He knows the only way that he can win this championship is to beat Ryan Hughes on the racetrack. So now the pressure squarely on the shoulders, and Ryan Hughes looks like he made contact there. That was Jason McCormick there on a Honda. We thought at first that it was number 19 Michael Craig, but boy, that was a tight moment for Ryan Hughes.
Well, he just squeezed through there. He looked like he was already had squared it. And what happened, which I think was actually a blessing for Ryan Hughes, you can see they've watered the track. So now the riders are riding at the very edges where it's dusty. So Ryan was just trying not to follow, and it's a good thing. Otherwise, he could have been caught up in that wreck. You can see how muddy Ryan Hughes is right now. Look at all the muddy. He can't even see. He may use most, if not all, of his vision before this moto's over with.
When they water the track, and you said they now try and find the dusty parts of the circuit, does that now try and squeeze it down to one line? Does it make passing harder?
Yeah, it definitely will. And it'll make it even tougher when you're behind a rider and he's squirting you in the face with mud. You only have so much vision, and you've got to try to take different lines, and there's only one fast line. So that's going to make, right now, the way things sit, Lampson is looking real good.
But look at the crowd get into it. The crowd is waving. They're really trying to motivate Ryan Hughes. They want to see a championship battle. They want to see, wow, he's closed that gap quickly on Mike Brown.
Yeah, he sure has. And it's like he said, it's all or nothing. This is winner take all, final moto of the year. This is what you like to see. It's come down to this. Look at this. Look at the aggression of Ryan Hughes right to the inside of Mike Brown. He said he's going to win or crash. He could have taken them both out right there. It was an aggressive move, and Brown was smart to just let him have that room.
Wow, that was a case of holding the throttle wide open, just getting in there, getting aggressive. Ryan Hughes is definitely a great show to watch when he gets on fire, starting to go to the front. But Mike Brown, of course, still potentially, I guess, alive in the championship if maybe the top two guys fell over. But right now, just trying to stay in contest with Ryan Hughes. Our Honda field summary shows, in fact, of course, Lampson, Hughes, and Brown. Pishon, Scott Sheik, nice start for the privateer.
Back at
Delmont, Pennsylvania, Jan Bikas, David Bailey, Art Ekman. A championship battle unfolding. Ryan Hughes right there has made his way past. Mike Brown has his sights set on the leader, but David, it's going to be a tough job. He's got mud all over him already. His vision is somewhat obscured, and the track conditions have really changed.
Well, yeah, it really frustrates me to see. I remember when I was racing, I would really be upset with it. But you can see that they've watered the track so much. And, you know, I understand they got to try to keep the dust down. But this is a championship battle. Winner take all or nothing, the final moto of the year. And they go and water it what looks like too much. And that'd be like in tennis, you know, between sets. They go out and move the lines around a little bit and mess with the surface of the court, you know, during a championship match. And it's really something that the riders were irritated with, and it's going to make Ryan Hughes' job today a little bit tougher. These guys are versatile, though, and they can deal with a lot of things. There's no question about that.
Motocross, certainly one of the toughest sports in the business, both physically and, of course, mentally. Like you said, David, changing the surface effectively in between races. But right now, Ryan Hughes has to absolutely uncork it, go for it, try and close that gap on Lamson. He's done it before. And, of course, we know that he a lot of times likes coming from behind, but I'm sure it's going to make him sit back and watch as well to see if Ryan Hughes can do one of his patented come-from-behind, no-holes-barred style of riding. Let's watch him for a moment, David, and observe his riding for us.
Well, he's going pretty fast, and little bobbles here and there, which would lead you to believe if you just tuned in that he's riding a little bit out of control, but... Well, that's the way Ryan always looks. You know, in the track right now, it really facilitates riding a little bit out of control and getting sideways, as you see him doing right there. But he caught Lamson in the first moto, passed him, then he passed Windham and put the pressure on Steve Lamson. And it appears right now, you know, he's about 5 seconds behind. That's not much. They got a lot of time left in this moto, and Ryan's got the speed to go up and catch him. Little mistake there, but he doesn't lose any time. That's the thing about Ryan. He makes mistakes, but he keeps going fast.
The fans are getting into it. You saw them there in the background. They desperately want to see these two guys decide the championship handlebar to handlebar. If it were to finish now, of course, Steve Lamson would be the champion. Whoever wins this moto will go home the champion in 1995. The fans absolutely enjoying this racing this afternoon. Lamson, you can't say enough about this guy. He came from over 60 points behind and now has an opportunity, potentially, to go home the champion.
Well, I don't know if when he first race or first two or three races back, he thought he would ever be sitting in this position. But now that he is, he's trying to take advantage of it. He got the hole shot when he needed it. And things are looking good for him right now, although he cannot rest because Ryan Hughes is the kind of guy that can make up 3 or 4 seconds in a lap. And whoever wins this title today is going to walk away with about $150,000 to $200,000, the number one plate, and they're going to be always regarded as a 125 national champion of 1995. So it's a huge, there's so much at stake here today, and these guys both have got to be riding nervous.
A huge difference between going home the champion and coming in second place in the championship. There's no comparison. You remember the champion, not who came in second.
Right, and there's no bonus for second place either.
Now, of course, we know how nervous Steve Lamson was in moto number one, but we knew also how nervous Mike Gosselaar was. Art Ekman is with him again here in moto two.
Mike, what did you say to him between motos? He hasn't made a mistake. He's had a tremendous pace.
Well, I kind of told him where he was losing time last moto. Then Jeremy came in and told him the same thing, and he kind of drew it out for him what lines he needed to take, and they look like they're working for him.
Where was he losing the time that he's picking up now?
Yeah, mainly that uphill jump section there, and Jeremy gave him some good tips on how to get through there, and they seem to be working real good.
That's got to be a huge boost for Steve Lamson. This is the section that they're talking about right here where he's able to make up a lot of time. You see he sits down on the seat right there to get more compression to the suspension to help him get over that jump, which just by the top of that hill, he's going so much faster. What has Ryan Hughes got going for him? I mean, not really much of anything. Lamson has got the strength of Team Honda. He's got Jeremy McGrath. Also, Jeff Stanton, his first appearance since a near-fatal accident. He decided to support Steve Lamson. Lamson was there when he was laying on the ground in severe pain. He's here for Steve Lamson today, and that's got to give him a big boost.
A lot of people behind this factory Honda effort, of course. Today, also, the 250 championship will be decided with Jeremy McGrath, the favorite there. Our Honda field summary shows Lamson on top, and in the second set, you see Huffman in sixth. A nice run for Windham, recovering now. Jan Bikas and David Bailey coming to you from Delmont, Pennsylvania, where, along with Art Ekman, we're watching the championship battle unfolding here in moto number two. Steve Lamson there, number five. He leads it, but at the moment, it looks like he's shaking off that arm pump, and he might be pulling away from Ryan Hughes. Back in sixth place, Damon Huffman looks like his championship hopes are over.
Well, he's definitely a fast 125 rider and a very talented, promising future, but he's had a frustrating season outdoors, and that frustration just continuing today. And the first moto gets stuck in the starting gate, having to come all the way from dead last. And right here in sixth place in the second moto, not really where the battle is, and a frustrating season.
However, if things were to finish as they are now, he would come home third in the championship. Last year, he was seventh in the 125 outdoors, so big improvement for him.
Sure, big improvement, and if Ryan Hughes or Steve Lamson moves up to the 250s next year, that opens the door for him a little bit, and I would think that he would be a championship contender next season. You can see right there, almost 4.5 seconds between Ryan Hughes and our leader, Steve Lampson. And I think Hughes, it's not over yet. This guy is, he's gonna keep trying, and I guess the thing that's happened is Steve Lampson has just picked this moto to ride fantastic, and he's really put the pressure on Ryan Hughes to ride above and beyond his best riding ability. Probably it's gonna force him to ride over his head like we've talked about before, and he's gonna have to do that to catch Lampson.